me and a friend were on a photography website, and he actually saw a picture that looked really cool of an old hospital. We knew where it was, this place. We went and found the hospital and had a look. I think we were only there about an hour, but it was massive. So we said, we'll go back. Then we spent about 6 hours in the place. And it's just like a bit of a bug. Do you know what I mean? The bug caught, and it was like, right, we'll find somewhere else. So we did.
I find it really difficult to put my finger on why I do it, but I just do.
It's not something that the average photographer would do. It's something different.
It's pretty much trying to signify what once was.
Even in a building like this that is all decayed, every single person here is going to have a different idea of what's beautiful about it. Sometimes, like, if you get right into it, you can almost hear how it would have been.
Now it's so silent, it's empty, you can virtually create the sound in your head of what it once was. Try and provoke a mood, a thought through the photography.
Thank you.
The reason why we keep going from premises to premises, office block to office block, factory to factory, is simply because ultimately we'd like to think that we can open a door that maybe nobody else have opened, find something that maybe hasn't been found yet. There is always an itch to be scratched. Something frozen in time. You could probably pick it up and it'd crumble in your hands, and yet it's intact.
You find chairs, there's always a chair. Every single building's a chair.
If it's a chair on its own, maybe in the center of the room or a corner of a room and nothing else, it is kind of final. The fact that the person have once sat in that chair and have now gone, you don't know where or when or how or what happened, it promotes a mood of sort of sadness.
People that don't understand what we do don't have a clue. There's some places you can just walk straight through the door and in. All right, there might be some fencing and stuff, but that's part of the challenge. You climb the fence, you don't knock the fence down, you don't damage the fence. We don't break in anywhere.
I respect what they do, and I respect their privacy and their reluctancy to share locations.
So I built my trust by getting out there, doing homework, doing recce of places, and getting maps, pinpointing history. I don't know who you are. I'm not tourist information. Do it your fucking self.
Thank you.